Why did my reputation go up? Hey everybody, Seven here. And thank you so much for joining me in the Octobo.
Be a bit annoying.
Dragging out the boat. Now, okay, cool. This is in a holding pattern. But I have complete faith in Derwin to run the town. Listen, everything's fine. Yestovia's fine. Alright, we need to get out to Astoya. Do we have any damages? Oh, joy of joy. We finally have a season where only one thing broke. Alright, so we only get the food storage that's busted. Should probably just wait until, that's looking good. Yeah, this will be no sweat. These guys will have this handled. We got plenty of tools. Yeah, so food storage is the only thing that's busted. I'm gonna hold off on doing any of the upgrading. I'm thinking we're probably gonna slip in a big old tin mining at some point. What else besides tin mining? Well, I say what else. Man, every time there's some quest that I'm unsure of, it's either, oh, this'll probably take us all day, or, you know, oh, this might be a multi-season kind of thing. Yeah, and then, man, we're just perpetually out of straw. We gotta get out of this whole straw technology era. Which, you know, the funny thing is, you'd think that with the amount of threshing we're doing, because the only thing we're growing right now is grains. We're growing, you know, the wheat, the oat, the rye, all that action. You'd think that we'd be threshing so damn much that we'd be just drowning in straw, but... Well, the straw is also being almost right straight turnaround time, right back into the animal feed, so... Alright, yeah, we are using a bit of it. Oh crap, we also still only have 2 barn workers. The farm shed has 4. But the barn's still only a level 1, it's only got 2 people in it. Not a crazy pressing thing to address. Like, it's not a major issue. Especially since we've already got the 2 houses that are empty anyway. Oh, right, I was gonna start a construction project as well, wasn't I? We don't need the houses. Like I said, we have 2 that are empty already. The thing is, we were just, you know, looking for any kind of building technology because I want that frickin' mine. And I just ran right past the storage. So... Yeah, tin mining is definitely going to happen at some point. I might just cut it completely off camera. I love playing with the voice altering and the echoes and stuff like that, but... I mean, there's only so much excitement you can give to tin mining. A necessity of the game, but not exactly thrilling video to watch. Oh, hunting XP. Yeah, hunting XP. We definitely need to... We need a bigger life bar. We also need to stop taking so much damage. The crappy thing is, you know, we're not exactly hunting per se ourselves, but why did I pick a location that had Wizens literally on top of Bear? We have perks that are in that we're going to want, because some of the combat has been kind of rough. Apparently I also have some really gross cheese on me and just a ton of rot. No clue where I got the rot, but that's relevant. Let's get rid of some of that stuff. We also have a handful of bolts that I meant to sell last season that I totally forgot to. Also, the storage situation is completely out of control. I just looked in there and it was 1800, I think it was at. Yeah, so... I actually reserved it to the old standby of, I took 50 logs out of there, 100 planks, threw them on the ground. That's a later problem. Alright, so let's get out to Astoya, finish that up, and then we'll get with Derwin. Alrighty, let's see what these guys have to offer. You there. Welcome. How are the elections? Is everything going as planned? I'm afraid we're at a stalemate. There are a few villagers who refuse to vote. I assume they haven't decided to vote for it yet. The problem is that we don't have any time restriction for voting, so the elections can't come to an end. Oh wait, if only a handful vote, like, did one of them get a majority vote? Like, what? The thing is, we never needed a time constraint since everyone wanted to vote as quickly as possible. So the feasting could begin. But in those days, we always had just one candidate for the village warden. This time, it's a mess. Your customs make you sound made up. Okay, these answers are funny, but they're terrible. Is there anything I can do to help? I can't intervene myself. It can be viewed as manipulation of votes. But you, on the other hand, could ask around what problems trouble the hesitant villagers. That's a fine idea. Who hasn't placed their vote yet? First one is Nyoko, who's run away from the village without prior voting. His wife was looking for him. You've already proven yourself effective in bringing back missing people. There's also young Radamelia, who's oddly distracted and refuses to make her decision yet. And finally, there's an old fishman, Viesbra. The man took offense to the whole village and lost all sense and reason. I have no idea what came to his mind since he has never expressed a complaint before. Maybe you'll find a way to get to them and convince them to make a decision. I do always find a way. You can already start gathering. You know, I'll give it a shot, man. I never guarantee anything to an NPC. Hi there. Oh, it's you again. Yeah, it's me again. I heard your husband left the village for unknown reasons. What happened? Don't even get me started on this coward. He ran to hide behind Piastovia's walls since he's afraid of bandits sacking our village. I haven't seen him so afraid since our wedding night. Of course, he proposed that I accompanied him to the town, certainly out of fear of my wrath and not of my concern. But I did not run away from the hustle and bustle of the city to go back to it just like that. Besides, I'm sure all he does is drinking like a fish at the local tavern. Getting drunk is... That sounds like a personal attack. Jesus, Redricube. I mean, what's to say he's overreacting? I mean, listen, have you stuck your head out of any village lately? This place is positively crawling with bandits. There's more bandits out there than there are in the valley. Now, trying to find a safer place to defend yourself sounds perfectly reasonable. Then you're just as mental as my worthless husband and Misladar. I'm sure he's the one pouring stupid ideas into Winoko's ear. Look how they set me up. All the house chores have now fallen to my lot. I must admit that this sudden stroke of genius just to skip work is quite impressive, but I'd rather have his clumsy bastard back already. Didn't he want to vote before deciding to leave? The bandit problem could still be resolved. I didn't get much out of his babbling. What I understood was whining that none of the candidates would make a change, and that there's no way of stopping the incoming threat, or something like that. I don't care. Just convince him to come back. You know, yeah, we have never once had the ability to swim. I doubt very highly that we're ever going to. You know, this seems especially poignant with today's current climate. Yeah, the worst thing is about any election, he's probably right. I'll go look for him. Oh, we can't knock out. Okay, it's going to be a step one, step two, step three kind of thing. All right, this is going to get expensive, but... Alrighty, let's see if we can actually track this guy down now. Well, she wasn't completely wrong. Hey, bud. Be welcome, stranger. You're new in this town, aren't you? Yes, I came here recently to enjoy the fine local beverages and taste a bit of town life. Is there anything I do to help you? Now, shouldn't he know me? Like, he should know that I know where he's from and where he belongs, I thought. I'm pretty sure he's the one that said, oh yeah, go south, because I saw him lugging logs and crap from the south. Thought, anyway. Things make it... Oh my god. You know what? I was going to push into, like, hey, you've got a job to do, but... Nah, you've got some interesting carved rocks there. None of them are for sale. They're a family heirloom from my past life. You wouldn't find any use for them anyway. I believe these stones have a higher purpose. You know, there is an election that cannot be concluded without a full set of these. The whole village is waiting for me? Now going back seems even more impossible. They'll blame me for delaying the whole ceremony and all the decision making. What am I saying? Let them think whatever they like. I'm not coming back because of the bandit threat, not their opinions. Your vote could still change Stoya's situation. Both candidates have ideas on how to defend the settlement from a potential bandit threat. And if they're wrong, I'm not convinced by any of them. I won't come back until the roads are at least a bit more peaceful. Make the Oxbow a safer place and I'll consider making my way back. After all, this land is also your home to protect now. You know, man, where the hell were you last season when I'm out here cleaning the streets? I mean, listen, that could be an interesting... Yeah, the road's already safer because I've been here. Like, I have cleaned house on bandits. Oh, but what are you going to make me... Oh, or I could staff the guy. Oh, actually, okay. I'm seeing through... Basically, I'm not seeing it from an RP stance. I'm seeing it from what is the game going to then make me do? So, yeah, it's going to be go kill some bandits, go kill a Wizened or something, and then go buy him some stuff. Eh, F it. We need hunting XP. Times three? You know that's an RNG thing, right? Like, you don't just kill a Wizened and guaranteed get its skull. Three Wizened skulls. How did I know it was going to be Wizened? How did I know it was going to be Wizened? Of course it's going to be Wizened. It's always Wizened. Stupid Wizened. Well, take those. And that. I'm not selling that. I'm scared. Why? Wait a minute. How does a potion lose durability? Whatever. I'll take it. If we get poisoned, we get poisoned. Alright, it looks like there's a little flooded area not too far from home here. There's Wizened there. There's also bear there. I think the only thing I'm packing as far as knife is just a crappy stone knife. Let's go see if we got anything better. Well, good thing I didn't sell off all those crossbow bolts. Oh my god, the sun's setting already. Okay, this bear appears to have been deleted, which I now totally don't need because I thought that was a mine when I first laid eyes on it. I was like, oh, hey, great, a mine just up the street. Are we out of animal feed? Man, what do you mean we don't have any bags? Man, I cannot express to you how much I do not want to hire a tailor. I just don't. Okay, 10 out of Doom for a bit. Now I'm going to be hunting Wizened in the dark. Super cool. Fun times were had by all. Alright, let's see if we can find this location now. A location generally has, like, what, 3 to 5 of them anyway? I doubt we're gonna get a 1-to-1 ratio on this. I'm hoping that because it's part of a quest, it's gonna be increased proportions, like an increased drop rate, maybe? We'll see. Alright, that's a moose. Oh. The music suddenly changed, and I was like, oh, this is not good. Okay, that's a bear. Yeah, moose! Beat it, man! Why did I pick a location that had Wizens literally on top of bear? Okay, there we go. There's three. I'd really rather take them as a perimeter. Why did I have to shoot my mouth off over how many bandits I took out? Oh, are you gonna clip through the tree? Oh, you are injured enough to run. Listen, man, you may be smarter, faster, turn on a dime now, but you still get stuck in a tree. Oh, why is the skull times one? And you know, all that XP that I keep whining and crying about, this is going to be a good source of that. I want attention from exactly one of you. Oh, and this looks like a good one. Look at how tight these trees are. Not in love with the distance, though. I'm also not in love with the side of your head. I'd like the front of it. Oh, hold still. Man, cut it out. The far one is giving me a better shot. Alright, you know what? If he's not going to play ball, we'll just move to a better position. There it is. Where are you? Oh, that's not cool. That's a bad time. Oh, that Wizened in a straight line is going to chase me down like no business. Oh, boy. Where'd the bear go? Yeah, well, there's the Wizened. Oh, times two. That's not good. That is really, really not good. Get up on top of it. Okay. Everything's pitch black. I can't see. You can't see. We'll get creative with editing in that one, I guess. No stamina to get to Hunter Sense. That's cool. That's a fun time. Where? One of them fell. Let's see what a 9% healing potion does. All right, never mind. That was fine. Okay, now I am very likely going to up all of this in editing, but yeah, I literally cannot see anything unless I use Hunter Sense. Wait, okay, if angry music is playing, that means you turn to engage, or are you running? I think you ran. But you had a friend. You definitely had a wingman. It's pitch black here. Also, that's not a wizened. That's not a wizened. No, we don't want none. Do bear and wizened fight each other? I know some of the predatory animals do actually fight each other, but I honestly don't know about those two specifically. I see this as an absolute recipe for disaster. Blind as a bat, with bandits, boar, wizened, and bear. Yeah, there's a boar out this way too. As if things couldn't get just a little bit more spicy. That lynx just scared the hell out of me. Oh, and apparently we're getting very, very close to wolf territory. Man, I don't think I've ever seen it this dark at night. This is unreal. Wait, that's the bear. Why is it? Wait, that was the bear, but that was also a blood trail. I didn't shoot the bear. Oh, he's not stopping. Oh, come on, get him stuck in the train. You on me? I can't tell, I don't have a stamina. Okay, no, you're off. I think. I mean, they're all still yelling at me. Listen, cut it with the music, he's not here anymore. Thank you. All right. We're probably going to have to take that bear, just because, as wildly unsafe as it is to hunt wizened in its own right, hunting wizened with this guy just hanging around, you are stuck in something. Well, you're going to be stuck momentarily. Eventually, you're going to be smart enough to figure this out, and then that's going to be a very big problem for me. Yeah, there you go. Stay stuck. I know I'm not getting any kind of headshots or anything, but listen, just take it out. I like the way the crossbow sounds while you're in Hunter Sense. Sounds like a silencer. Oh, he's not. No, you're not dead. Okay. Running, but not dead. How far of a drop is this? Man, I swear, I don't know if torches are a benefit or a hindrance right now. Like, your immediate vicinity is brighter, but also, why can't I have my bolt back? Yeah, I honestly almost think that the torch out is worse when you're trying to use the Hunter Sense. What's that? I think it's the bear, and I think it's dead. Yes. Yeah, you're welcome. All right. There's at least two more. One injured. Although, these swampy sections, they're usually pretty rife. Oh, this here. Oops. These swampy sections are usually pretty rife with ore. All right, there's one. Times two. Here we go. I have nothing to hide behind. That was really stupid. That was a dumb plan. Okay, got him a good one, though. Was enough to make him run. Oh, crap. Hit the trees, please. Hit the trees. Hit the trees. Oh, that's a good noise. That's a good noise. Oh, I don't think they're going to fight each other. Oh, and those wolves are gonna get me too. Well, the sun's coming up at least. And I swear, it's almost like the bear, pigs, and wolves are like guarding this Wizen spot. I mean, since when are you guys all friends? Asked Pig. Which, realistically, is probably not a terrible idea to take out. I was gonna say, I know I didn't one-shot you. Yeah, I don't have that kind of technology yet. What? Little bastard? Beat it. I can one-shot you at that range. Huh? Oh. Get it loaded. Oh, we're gonna need these points. God, we need these points. I know, recurve bow. Oh shit, I'm getting double teamed, I think. What? All right, well, if I can't jump it, then they can't jump it. Now, I think one of my problems is I'm timing the distance and the speed that they're coming after me at as an older playthrough. You know, because once you get those skill sets, the crossbow will load and fire before they have time to close the gap. With no skills, they'll be on you before you can have it fully loaded. I swear to God, Fox. Like, listen, you want to have fun, we can have some fun. Beat you with a hammer. All right, so we're going, like, directly into wolf territory now. And I don't think I've taken a single one. There you are, hi. Shut it. Yeah, now we're overloaded. Now, if the entire 100-acre wood is done trying to eat me, I have two frickin' buffalo. The only things I was actually out here for. Also, good, you two are far enough apart that this isn't gonna draw your friend's attention either. There it is, there's that. And one of you should be pretty injured. Yeah, you want a piece? There's that. Go, still coming, still coming, still coming. Load, please. That should make you run. Nope, you're not running. I was expecting the third hit to make you run. It did. Good. See, that's the other thing. Knowing the damage of the weaponry that you're carrying, is it going to be two to make them not want to chase you, or is it going to be three? Turn around. Never mind. Okay, let's see if the quest has it weighted. That'd be really nice. Please. No. Oh, so we're getting increasingly heavy here. After we take this guy, we definitely gotta go home. Alright, there's that. Back it up, back it up. Where's your face? Where's your face? Where's your face? No, seriously, where's your face? I can't even see you. Running? Running. See, that's why I like the crossbow. Yes, the recurve is faster, but the damage of the crossbow, if you leave it up to timing and anticipation, you shouldn't actually get hit. I'm just playing like an idiot. I'm playing like I don't have level 10 hunting, which I've still never gotten. I have a chip on my shoulder. Oh, there's two. All right. That's likely, yep, grayed out. All right, let's run home. We'll jump off just Omaha steaks worth of stuff. And we'll go after that one by the river. Oh God, this is gonna take a bit. I'll see when we get home. Also, oh geez, I thought we were gonna just have this one done. You know, our poor quartermaster friend over there is waiting on a decision from us. I thought we were gonna have a decision like, hey, let me come back in next week. I was not expecting all of this. The thing is, yeah, I do expect following this quest line result in having a third option to talk to him about. But ultimately, at the end of the day, I think I still have my decision. I mean, it's definitely not going to be Skalky guy. I've already taken that right off the table. You know, he's retired, his son has taken over. You know, he has openly, deliberately said, yep, I'm ready to devote more time to my wife and my family, and yeah, so I'm not going to hit him with that. Now, the hunter in Klonika, the actual real father of their leader, he seems like a fantastic choice. But I also don't know what the results of this election thing are going to be and what that is going to then entail for possibly talking to the quartermaster. Now, let me just not be heavy and go kill another buffalo. All right, now, because I am completely disinterested in fighting any more pigs, I think I can avoid them in the water. Also, I'm dirty, and if I have to eat anything, I don't want the poison to hit me. Oh, crap, you know what? I never did check out that tent that was out in the middle of nowhere. We saw that campfire while I was running from, well, everything. All right, this should be pig area, and I think on the other side of this bridge should be the Wisens. Okay, actually, they're very much upstream. That's fine. Oh, you know what? We're here. These islands always compel me. Like, I can't just not come on one of these islands. That, I'm pretty sure we've already come across it. We have not come across this one before. Interesting. All right. Hey, 150 bucks too. That's cool. Oh, actually, full wine bottles. That's very nice. All right. A little bit of cash. I mean, it actually wasn't on the island, but we wouldn't have seen it if we hadn't gone to the island. Discovered animal spot, what? Wait, discovered? Oh, there's two of them. All right, we got, holy crap, what was that, four? Now, time was, you could really cheese the hell out of water, and certain animals just, like, looked at it like an impenetrable barrier. I'm kind of liking this idea, but that's far. Also, this is cleared out. No bandits. Well, everything's saying empty. Okay, I'm picking up what you're putting down now. Yeah, every sack is empty, every barrel is empty. I'm pretty sure I probably already tore this place up. Yeah. Oh, very cool. All right, but then what's the best course of action? Try to gamble on the water or to try to gamble on the building? You know, the other thing is, the draw distance in this game is pretty impressive, and you can launch a bolt and still hit your target from quite a ways away. Oh yeah, he's not liking that. Oh, but now he's hiding behind friends. All right, that was a hit. All right, you know what? Let's take out the friend too. I think that was a hit. And yes, I wasn't kidding when I said I still don't have level 10 hunting. It's actually the only achievement in the game I don't still have, or I don't yet have. Oh, that's not good. That's not good. That's not good. That's not good. Oh, I'm going to want you to run away. Okay, so important safety note, they will cross the water now still. Oh, crap. See, there's this weird gray area between, oh, you've damaged it enough to run away, but then you've damaged it too much that now it knows that it's got to fight for its life. Okay. Is that two dead or three dead? Well, there's three skulls at least. Eh, F it, I'll still take the beaten resources. and the XP, because it's not just killing the thing that gives you XP. Harvesting it will give you the XP as well. Oh my, I thought you were dead. Are you even injured? Are you the one that I tagged already? Oh, come on, man. Time this right, please. Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah, timing's one thing, so is accuracy, you idiot. What? How far are you planning on running? Also, I swear I killed at least one. I'm thinking I got ripped off somewhere along the way here. Listen, pal, just don't. Listen, man, you forget a million things every day. Make sure this face is one of them. Yeah, real cool. Real cool. Okay, now that this season is half over with. Oh my god. Alright, so let's get this guy a couple of Wizened Skulls. I don't want to get into this engagement. Did I just hear Growl and Oink? Come on, get off me! Potions, 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 potions. That's fun. You've got potions. I just Razmir casually sprinting through the woods, slugging potions as fast as he can. Oh, and you know what? Somebody actually did tell me about the stamina potions. They're like, oh yeah, there's stamina potions too. You should probably start carrying some of those around. Yeah, like when you're running for your life and you ran out of stamina and you can't sprint anymore. Yeah. Instances like that. It'd be a good call. It'd be a really good call. Well, at least we're home again. We can dump off some of the excess weight again. Although, speaking of excess weight, that storage facility is getting bad. Food storage is fine, but the resource storage is just completely out of control. Honestly, the thing that would fix it the best is actually if we got the mine. We'd pull off the extraction shed guys, maybe leave one there, but then we'd leave ourselves with probably just one lumberjack and a bunch of miners. Okay, that's 100 logs and 200 planks right there. Anyway, we gotta make some moves. But yeah, so the best sort of solution that I can think of, we actually just need less people on wood. The extraction guy on all that copper, that's necessary because we're still stuck in the copper age, which sucks. But we also have him bringing in a really good amount of limestone, which is going to make for happiness, which is going to make for everybody better at their jobs, which is just all around good. But the thing is, I don't want to just take the lumber shed and just, oh, let me just dial down everything. Yeah, that would be the immediate solution, but then that lumberjack, you know, him going from, say, 4 to 5 is going to take that much longer because he's just not bringing in as much resources as he could be. So dumbing someone down is my last option when it comes time to, like, how to control the weight. If he was a level 10, I'd be like, okay, listen, you're a level 10, just shut it down. You're fine. Alrighty, my man, I have presents. The Oxbow Bandits must have wetted their pants as they heard me slay those wild beasts. Those scumbags deserve to live in fear, but how can I believe you? How do you track the beasts without a hunter? And what about the trophies? Yeah, I really don't need anybody to. I have hunter instinct, hunter vision. I'll look up the skill in a minute. Well, okay, yeah, they're not hard to miss. And usually, if I'm honest, they find me. Because believe it or not, I do tend to miss a giant buffalo the size of a frickin' house just careening at me at 60 miles an hour. Oh, wait a minute. I think this one might give him less fear about the bandits and be like, oh, wait, we have a bigger threat. No. Don't worry about it. I covered it. They're so heavy, you can barely lift them. Have you seen the size of them? I see you don't make empty promises. Maybe this land is not going to get plundered when folks like you are wandering around. After all, no one bothered me on my walk here. Fine, I'll go back. Don't forget to vote! You know what? No, it was a pleasure. I needed the XP anyway. Okay, lady, it only took me a day and a half, but guess what? Your husband's coming home. Hello. Master Ceremony told me you still hasn't we just jumped right to it. Okay. Ah, yes, I almost forgot about it. It'll be my first time voting, you know? But I'm really hey, look at that. You're age 18. Wild. But I'm really busy right now. There's some important chores that can't wait. You made me lose focus. What was I about to do? Okay. Yeah, if you're stressed about the election, it's completely natural. No, stones can wait. What's the hassle about anyway? If you care so much about my vote, help me finish my preparations. I mean, everything needs to be wrapped up before the ceremony. What? The details are not your concern. Just know that I have a lot to do before the celebration kicks in for good. Here, take this dress and get it to the seamstress. I'll take care of my hair in the meantime. They're in an awful state. Okay. Trivial, unnecessary task, my expertise. Render Cube, I love you. Right, I'll pass it on to her. Oh, okay, I was not expecting there to be a tailor right here in town. That's convenient. Ooh, only level one, though. That's a bummer.
What's going on?
Oh, hi. What are you carrying there? Is it for me? A lady named Radmila asked me to bring this to you for sewing up. Again? Show me this rag. That smell, oh gosh. When will this lass start to take care of herself like a proper lady? She's always so giddy and carefree. Any moment now, and she'll hurt herself again. What? But we wouldn't like that to happen, would we? Come back later, sweetie. I'll handle the dress. What? Boy, is she just, like, crazy accident prone or something? All right, lady. The tailor's got you covered. Hello. Your clothing is in good hands now. Of course it is. She's a master needlewoman. Unfortunately, that's all of the abilities that fate has given her. But let's... What, you saying she's, like, level one extraction and level one farming and... I need 8 vases for the flowers I gathered. A trip to the city is not an option for me. I promised not to hit the trail for a while, and I still have more chores in the village. Oh, and I need 4 honeycombs as well. Amelia always gets on my nerves about my smell. So now I'll be sweet and floral all over. Wait, would that attract the bugs too much? Whatever, we'll worry about that later. Now the most important thing for you to do is gather all the necessary items. Fancy a mare to match the rest. That's pretty good too. No, we'll just go with the snarky answer on this one, I guess. Hey, you want to be just a horse too? Don't mock me. Do you want me to use my voting stones or not? The sooner you go, the sooner we're finished. Oh, and by the way, collect my dress from the seamstress on your way back. That's all. Safe journey. It's good for your heart, not sure about the mind, though. Yeah. Why do I feel like I care more about this village than people who actually live here? Sheesh. Alright, lady, can I have that dress back? I'm back to collect the dress. You'd make a fine one, no doubt, but she'll learn modesty one day when the prince turns out to be just gullible girl's dream. Take it from the drying rack. It's all fresh and sewn up. Oh, and by the way, dear, tell this reckless butterfly not to get into trouble and refrain from doing pointless chores. I'll need her to be at full strength. But wait, why don't you tell her herself? You just live just right next to each other. Talk to her. It's enough for me that I have to wash her dirty rags and take care of her well-being. I have no intention of chasing her around, just to state the obvious. You know what? Forget it. Just take the dress and be done with it. The mysterious art of dialogue, it's not for everyone, it seems. Man, this town is batshit. All the other towns, like, they made sense. You guys are frickin' weird. Get some honey. Never mind, I forgot to actually get the dress. There we go. Hi. Fresh laundry. Take all the laundry with... No. Which one's hers? The one's dress is brand new. It's clean, sewn up, and you also notice some tailoring alterations. No one will notice. Just take it. And I'm dirty again. Shocker. Let's just get there. Okay, now, the crappy thing is... Wait, I already have 6 honeycomb on me. Cool. Clay vase. the goods trader is only gonna have like actual flirting gifts. Right. Yeah, that's literally all you've got.
Can I interest? Have a good day.
I'm trying to think, like, who the hell would I talk to about this? Usually there's like a resource trader. Yeah, what about you there? Hi.
Hello.
You have bottles. Outstanding. What'd you say you needed?
Goodbye.
Eight.
How are you?
Hi.
Can I take care?
Okay. I'm really carrying 6 honeycomb on me somehow. Okay. I'm just gonna take your word for it. I have no recollection of when I got that. All right, one more chore done. All right, lady. Where are you? Got the dress. Got the vases. Got the honey. Also, you know what? Lady, if you want to get yourself better off, that's usually how I do it. There, you see how well that worked out? Hi, I got all your stuff. I have all the items you asked for. Wonderful. I've also been busy and gathered everything that I need. It's going to be perfect. One last task for you. Take all the things and bring them to the meeting stone in the orchards. It's a quiet place without any prying eyes around. When you're there, put the wine jug on the left and the juice on the right. Flower vases should stand back. Don't make any rearrangements. I'm meeting someone important there. We'll talk about my vote later. Oh, I love decorating. Actually, I really hate it. I have no aesthetic eye for anything, and oh man. I've been playing this game for quite a while and still never got the hang of that. Yeah, I almost forgot why I was doing this. Can't wait. All right, wine on the left, juice on the right, vases in the back. I'm 80% sure that's how she said it. Okay. Wine on the left, juice on the right. Wait, man, why is there always one detail that I gloss over? No, it definitely said vases. So this is the only thing that's even mentioning vases. Okay. All right, walk away and give the pair some space. Wait, listen to see if the meeting. So I'm eavesdropping. I go back around the. Oh, and it's cover of darkness even, too. You put in a lot of effort to make this meeting special. Thank you, but you didn't have to. You'd be resting. Wait, Ludmere. I feel fine. I have to keep myself busy somehow. You told me not to leave the village, remember? Wait, isn't Ludmere the guy that I rescued? Of course, I understand. But it's for your safety. How's your health? Are there any signs already? Oh. I'm all right. I told you. It's the little one that will need the attention now, not me. It's happening. I can feel it. That's wonderful. Except for the celebrations? Good girl, I'm very proud of you. It's for you. Us. The whole three. Yes, how could I forget about Nymilla? Now my wife will finally be all smiles. We've been waiting for this moment our whole lives. I'm very confused. I meant, never mind. Surely she will be pleased. This is like a surrogacy kind of thing? Amelia almost lost all hope, and now she'll feel the joys of life again. You are a blessing, Redmelia. I'm happy that I could help both of you. You must take care of your health and be very cautious. Of course, you'll be rewarded as I promised before. You won't have to worry about anything anymore. We'll provide you with everything you need, even when the little one leaves your care. Thank you. You will be a great seamster or shepherd, I'm sure of that. Yes. Oh. Oh. Kid, I am real sorry about that. That did not go according to plan. Oh, Oh, it's you. I knew your voice sounded familiar. Your voice sounded... Did I just seriously say that your voice sounded familiar? Did I just seriously say that? Radmila, did I actually... Name. Your name sounded familiar. Your voice sounded familiar. Your mother... What a bad Bresnier. Crap. Wait for next morning. Tin. Let's go get Tin. Alright, let's run home, gear up a little bit. And the one mine is guarded exclusively by rabbits, which is the only critter on the map that hasn't frickin' attacked me. Maybe I'll make a couple extra torches too. I have no idea what the life is left on this one. No. Not much. Oh, right. Hunting XP. Well, that was the last one, apparently. Oh, thank you. Now, unfortunately, because... Wait, effect even stacks... Take it... Oh, interesting. I did not know that that had multiplayer implications to it. That's very cool. Now, yeah, I absolutely would have loved to have taken some of the more combat effective skills that were there. You know, durability loss or load speed increase. You know, that would have been great. But increasing the traps is going to increase how much XP I can get. Cool. Well, no, we should do it. We should do it because upgrading is going to be building XP. I'm certain I don't need this many sticks, but whatever. So the thing that I'm kind of trying to look at is, okay, by having extra traps, now we've got extra XP that we're generating. And in one of my playthroughs, I actually almost made it. I almost got to level 10 before I called. What? I swear to God I had 4. Okay. Now that we've proven that I can't read and can't count. Oh shoot, you know what we didn't take? Yeah. Alright, that might be the next one. I really want level 10 on this playthrough. And it feels like we might be wrapping up the story soon. This might have to get accelerated. Which means I might need to get dedicated a couple of nights to going out and shooting things. And yes, I am aware that I've just been casually wandering around with my health at like a third. Listen, I don't plan on getting in any more fights. I'm fine. I'm probably fine. Plus, I know that there's going to be like 3 or 4 of you that are just absolutely tweaked out by that. My buddy Sea Dog is probably chief among them. And running around on 0 HP and having nothing bad happen about it while he freaks out, that just makes me happy. It's just a fun time for me. And then, of course, I get it from both ends, because Dinkers is always commenting on my food and water. Sea Dog always comments on my health. Alright, so we've got a little bit of weight just from dumb crap to sell that we don't necessarily need, but I'm honestly just gonna throw it all into the chest. Oh my god, is sun seriously coming up already? We didn't get any tin. No. I'm not ready for morning yet. God, where is the season gone? Alrighty, let's get out to that mine. Hopefully not run into anything now that I'm completely unarmed. Alright, well, listen, I couldn't completely deny myself messing around with the voice a little bit. Alright, we're only here for the tin. We'll grab all of that, throw all the stone on the floor, ignore all the copper, and we'll clear this place out as best we can, and then race off to the quest. Alright, I'll see you guys in a sec. Well, unfortunately, I'm thinking this one might kick it. Oh, and we are just barely too heavy. So all the skills that were, well, useful in that tree, we got the knowledge of. That's required, you know, especially early game. Like, that's one of the most important early game skills you can get. And so I dumped 2 points into this. I mean, okay. When I'm out manually mining, I'll get more. None of this really fascinated me. The idea of, you know, smacking a rock and you get 3 tin out of it versus smacking a rock and getting 5 tin out of it, Yeah, I'll take that action at least. We don't necessarily need the production technology, or the XP for that matter. But I am probably going to smelt the crap out of all of this, just for the weight issue. You know, two ore into one bar cuts down the weight, and then bar of tin and bar of copper to a bar of bronze cuts down the weight. Yes. Okay, listen. We're going to take a couple of hours. We're going to race out there. We're going to do this.
We should hire a private wagon.
What? Alrighty, well, let me just smelt, and we should be able to come out of here with exactly 31 bars of copper then. I'll see you guys in a sec. Alrighty, well, we are going to have bronze 4 days. That really just means that I'll be able to make whatever I want to make out of bronze. I could reset the blacksmiths to start using it, but that would be too much of a headache. So the thing is, the excavation shed is pulling in way more copper than what we need. The blacksmiths are actually smelting all that copper into more bronze than what they need. So bronze ore and bronze bars are accumulating overproduction here. Wait, did I say copper or bronze? I meant copper. Copper ore and copper. The excavation shed's getting more copper than what the blacksmith knows what to do with. The blacksmith smelting is smelting that ore more than the other blacksmith is actually producing stuff knows what to do with. So copper is way overproduced. So, oh, nice. Wow. Yeah, that's what I like to see. All four of my guys just sitting around doing nothing with no flags. Nice job, guys. So the long and the short of it is, yeah, we're just monstrously over-harvesting and overproducing copper. Until we actually get a mine ourselves and can get the tin, I just don't want to mess with having the blacksmiths do anything with bronze, because, you know, okay, I'm going to have to single-handedly myself go out and get tin. And I don't want them flagging for stuff, and I don't want them, you know, oh, we don't have any tin to turn into, you know, bronze bars, and oh, we were out of bronze bars to make, you know, pickaxes and stuff. No, once we get the mine, then everything will just cycle itself over. For right now, let's get out of here. All right, so what even was this? Was this like some sort of surrogacy thing gone weird? I mean, the guy's clearly married. And also, I knew I recognized the name. That's the necklace guy. That was the previous mayor of this place. And man, he set me off the second I laid eyes on him. Like, that guy definitely threw me. So, I mean, is this on the level? Is this legit? Like, what even is this? Greetings. Did your meeting go well? Yes, everything's in order. I'll place my vote now just as promised. Thank you for your help. Well, listen, given that, you know, we're going to be voting, or well, you guys are going to be voting, and you're clearly having an affair with one of the candidates. Like, I mean, that alone adds a lot of illegitimacy to your vote. I mean, you need anything else? No, I have everything I need, at least for now. I'll manage. Don't worry about me. Here, take these drinks. I poured the rest of my wine and juice into some bottles. I have no use for them. They would only bring back memories of my disillusionment. Oh. I'll never forget. That's tragic. Yeah. Remember not to waste your love on someone who doesn't deserve it. Well, 4 juices and 4 wines. That's... Thank you. Voice of the people. A walker stalker? Oh crap, we still had the third person to track down. Oh my god. Hi. What's that about? I don't want any more problems. Oh, right, you're the one that... Right. I heard you haven't cast your vote for the new warden yet. And I don't intend to. I won't move a finger until my life gets back to normal again. It's misery. Being constantly mocked and followed by this monster, why did it have to favor my usual spots and not someone else's? We need to find you a drink. Oh my god. Okay, we're not doing that. There's no such thing as monsters. Maybe some herbs will help you calm down. Do you think I'm insane? I know what I saw. I won't get myself fuddled by any medications. I may be old, but my sight is still sharp as an eagle's. Yeah, I do like to take the even keel side of things. I understand that you're scared, but you can't keep the whole election on hold. Huh, let them wait. You won't make me let it go so easily. No one would bear the sight of those eyes staring at them every day. My vote must wait until they're gone. That's my last word. I already regret waking up today. Yeah, this one's gonna be a tricky one. Whoa, what the hell happened to my stick? Oh, it's some... Is it some kid screwing around again? Hello, sir. So you're this little monster disturbing the old fisherman. A monster? My mom sometimes calls me that when I don't want to go to bed. But I ain't doing anything bad now, just playing. You sure smell like a monster. Why aren't you with your parents? Do they know where you are? They're busy with the election. Besides, my sister Jabrakna is constantly nagging me, and I don't want to be around her. I'd rather be here. How could I convince you to play somewhere closer to your home? You can rub my sister's face with a rotten apple, that'll do. Tempting, but no. Yeah, how about I just whoop your ass and get it over with? Freaking 8-year-old kid, like... Yeah, she's probably nagging you to, like, actually do stuff. And violence will make you spiral even deeper into your conflict. And listen, she's gonna get older, you're gonna get older, then you're gonna be fighting, yeah. But I'm not moving a muscle, I'm fine here. I have a new craft to learn and I need space. You know what, kid? Yeah, we'll see about that. Where are your parents? Or your sister? It seems that your monster can talk since it's a little boy. You couldn't handle that yourself? Easy to say, it's still a monster. They're all ruthless. My own son never listened to my pleas. He got in trouble for stealing and had to redeem himself by serving in a local lord's army. I haven't seen the lad